In honor of Poetry Month, the Adams Center in Kingston held a one-man show called Robert Frost, Light and Dark, with actor, director, and writer J.T. Turner. PCN was invited in to bring you this story.
So I'm here at the Adams Center today for a performance of a play that I wrote called Robert Frost, Light and Dark. Robert Frost, I think, has to be, at least among Americans, people's favorite poet. They love him. Even people that don't like poetry love Robert Frost. And when I read about him, read about his life, one of the unfortunate things was he had a biography printed after he died that was very uncomplimentary. And it's only in the last few years that we've taken a more even-handed look at him and his life. So I wanted an opportunity for Frost to be able to talk in his own words, using some of his poetry as a background, about his life and times. So I have been a professional actor for most of my adult life. I started off at a very young age as a performer. I had a career as a banker, and then over time just grew tired of that. And a number of years ago, I decided it would make sense to start writing some of my own performance material that I could use in between gigs.
All the really good titles have been taken, mostly by those magazine fellows writing about me. Morning Frost, Frost in the evening, Frost in the afternoon, Frost heaves.
So it's a one-man performance. The pretense, I had to pick a place in Robert Frost's life where it would make sense for him to be talking to people while most of the major events had already occurred. So I chose him in the early 1940s. I set this particular piece at his cabin in Vermont, and he's invited some people over for him to read some of his poetry and talk a little bit about his life. And over the course of about an hour, 15 minutes, he shares some of his major poems with the audience. And he also shares a lot about his life that people may not have knowledge of.
I especially love in my poetry to capture the sounds, the rhythm, the cadence of New England. You can get away with a lot of mistakes if you come from a certain part of the country.
So I've always been a huge fan of Robert Frost, and I decided I would do a one-man performance about it. And I was really fortunate because one of my professors when I was at Emerson College, who I've stayed in touch with over the years, actually worked quite a bit with Robert Frost and knew him well. So with his help, I was able to develop a show and think about how to present it. And I did decide to do it first person, so I perform as Robert Frost. And choosing the voice and the poetry and all that, I had a lot of help. It took me about 2 years to get the whole piece together to where I was comfortable presenting it in front of an audience.
My family was deeply concerned that I would grow up and waste my life as a baseball pitcher. And I started writing poetry. Certainly baseball looked mighty good to them.
I'll just mention that I do a number of other historical characters. I perform as William Shakespeare. I have a one-man presentation of Charles Dickens doing A Christmas Carol. The author C.S. Lewis, who is a great Christian apologist and the author of Lion, Witch, and Wardrobe, and a number of other historical characters like Benjamin Franklin that I tour with.